Hey guys, how's it going? Tez back again with another episode of the AC Milan career mode here on Xbox One. And after making a couple of very, very good signings yesterday, bringing in Adam Jajic and Giovanni Dos Santos. If you want to see yesterday's video, if you missed it, there's an annotation in the bottom left-hand side of your picture. And of course, feel free to check the channel page and or the playlist for it. But we made a couple of signings. We freed up some extra cash by moving a couple of players on, having a bit of a fiddle with the transfer budget to try and bring in a centre-back. And as you can see, we've had offers for Phil Jones rejected. I put another one in there for him. We've had the offer for Leonardo Bonucci accepted, and we're going to offer him a contract. But before any of that progresses any further, we've got this game in the league against Hellas Verona. Now, we actually played Verona yesterday in the Coppa Nazionale, in the Italian domestic cup competition, and they actually held us to a 1-1 draw after 90 minutes. We had to, after 120 minutes even, we had to go to penalties before we were able to brush them aside and actually get the victory. But hopefully we can come out with a better performance and a better result, crucially, in this league game as well, because we're very, very close to the top of the league right now. We need to not let those teams in and around us get away from us if we possibly can. We've got Roma, Juventus, Inter Milan and Napoli are the four teams around us in the top five that's very, very close together. You've got three Champions League spots and two Europa League spots, and we need one of those top three to really stand a decent chance of having a or something that you can class as a successful season. And we got off to a good start. Mario Balotelli put us 1-0 up, and I was very, very pleased with that because he's been superb for us so far this season. Definitely the talisman of the team and the man that scores a lot of our goals. And hopefully we can come out with a victory from this one. Although, as you can see, Hellas Verona were creating chances. And one of those chances here was going to be taken. I was A, disappointed that he was able to get such a good cross in. B, disappointed that Abate lost the header. And C, disappointed that Victor Guita was beaten at his near post. So it was a bit of a calamitous goal, unfortunately, to concede. And we push into the second half, and they're going to threaten again. Unfortunately, it's just another tame shot that trickles wide of the far post. And that one chance in that first half was the only real clinical, clear-cut opportunity. But Honda's breaking down the right-hand side here. Plays the ball back to Robinho. He's going to try and find a ball inside to Ricardo Montolivo. Finds Balotelli. Great turn, great touch. And unfortunately, the goalkeeper makes a good save and keeps Balo out for a second time. But we're not done just yet. I don't want to settle for another 1-1 draw against this Verona side. I want to win. And Poli plays a gorgeous ball through to Balotelli. Wonderful first touch and an even better finish. Rifles it right into the roof of the net. Typical Balotelli finish and celebration as well. You know, really showing his muscles there, even though there's that picture, actually, isn't there, of him and Clarence Seedorf. Clarence Seedorf is just like smiling mid-conversation. He has the most ridiculous ripped six-pack you've ever seen in your life. And Balo is doing that celebration that he did at Euro 2012 with Italy, where he took his shirt off and kind of clenched all his muscles in that Hulk thing. And he just doesn't look anywhere remotely as buff. But anyway, we've had offers accepted. I got sidetracked there, didn't I? We've had offers accepted for Martin Caceres and Phil Jones. Now, we only really want to bring in one centre-back. I can't really afford to bring in two. And as you can see, we've had an offer put in for Robinho, but I wanted Sebastian Giovinco to replace Robinho, but that offer has been put on the side point. We actually rejected that one since we brought in Giovanni Dos Santos and Adam Yates. So I'm actually going to keep hold of Robinho till at least the summer to see what happens with any potential deals in the summer, bringing in a player of that sort of kind for the team, you know, the sort of centre forward and or wide player to fill the gap left by Robinho. But we've had contract offers declined by Bonucci and Caceres. They've got squad rotation roles at Juventus, and they wanted something more. Clearly, Juventus don't value their part in the squad if they're willing to let either or both of them leave. So I definitely want to get hold of one of them. So I offered them both important first-team players because, you know, they will technically be important first-team players because I do have a lot of rotation that goes on. I just didn't necessarily want to promise them something that they weren't necessarily going to get. But that's all aside, because we're playing top of the table Napoli right now. We played Roma, that were top of the league at the time, not too long ago, and we drew 2-2 with them. So where they sit now, a point behind Napoli, and we sit level on points with Roma, just a point behind Napoli. Now, if you remember, the first game of the Serie A season was at home against this Napoli side, and it was a very, very even fixture in which we missed a penalty. Mario Balotelli missed a penalty against Pepe Reina. Very realistic, in fact, that that actually happened in that game. And Napoli actually ran out 1-0 winners, 1-0, 1-0 winners, thanks to a deflected effort that fell to Lorenzo Insigne. So I wanted to get revenge here if we possibly could, and we had a couple of great opportunities in the opening 5 minutes alone. Ballo there really should have done better with that cross and header as it came in. Should have just found that bottom corner. There's no excuses though. I was particularly disappointed in him, and unfortunately El Shaarawy kind of had to dig out the shot that he had in the opening 90 seconds or so. But if I was disappointed in Mario Balotelli, Napoli's manager Rafael Benitez is going to be particularly and equally disappointed in Gonzalo Higuain there for missing that glorious opportunity to put Napoli 1-0 up. We push later on into first half stoppage time. Again, it's Ballo with the header, and again, Pepe Reina comes up with the save to keep him out. So we still haven't scored against Napoli yet in, hang on, test my maths, 90 plus 45, 135 minutes worth of football so far. But we've got a lot left to go. We need to make sure that we can get this win and or a draw if we possibly can. But fortunately, Vedran Barami isn't a very good shot, and that one went just wide. But into the second half, they definitely stepped their game up. Goran Pandev had come on for the injured Higuain, who'd gone off. Insigne cutting me deep again. Lovely turn inside. And that was that was an interesting effort. I wasn't expecting him to go for goal. And by the way, Guita threw himself at it, I don't think he was expecting him to go for goal either. But Pandev and Insigne were involved again here in this move. And Pandev's going to whip it out wide to Dries Mertens, who is a player I'm very much a fan of, who rips me apart down the right-hand side, squares it across. Pandev with this shot. And that is quite possibly the most soul-destroying, yet at the same time realistic goals we've had scored against us, or even scored in either this career mode or any career mode that we've done today. You'll see a couple of replays of this. It's just very, very unlucky. He squared it back. The defender's tried to block it. He stuck his foot out. And as Guita's gone down to collect it with his hands, watch Guita's arms here. He goes down to just bring it up to his chest. Just takes his eye off it for a second, and that deflection takes it past him and into the bottom left-hand side of the net. And it was so, so frustrating after, again, another very, very even game against Napoli, where either side could have come out with a victory. We were find ourselves 1-0 down, and again Balotelli, lovely cross, lovely header, and Pepe Reina has his positioning absolutely on point. It's just perfect positioning from the goalkeeper, and he's able to just pluck the ball out of the air. And it's so increasingly frustrating to have chance after chance after chance and still not be able to find a way past the Spaniard, and we still haven't scored against Napoli. We're pushing into the 93rd minute now. Another chance to score into Adam Yates. He brushes the defender off beautifully and then snatches at the effort. I thought the defender was going to come with me, so I snatched at a shot myself. It was my fault. I should have been more composed, taken a touch and slotted it home, but I snatched at it first time, and it just went wide of that far post. And unfortunately, we're going to take another 1-0 defeat against Napoli. That will move them 4 points clear of us at the top of the table. As you can see, we still sit on 44. They're now on 48, and Juventus and Inter have games in hand below us, as do Roma above us, although we are level on points with Roma. So still very, very tight in those European positions, and we are starting to pull away as a fivesome from the rest of the table. As you can see, Cagliari and Fiorentina sit there on 35 and 34 points respectively. So we're building up a gap in those European spots, but we want to build up a gap in those top three European spots, because Champions League is the main focus. But that's going to bring this particular episode to a close, guys. Thank you very much for watching. There will be a My Player episode for you later on tonight at 9 o'clock. Do be sure to tick your sub boxes for that later on this evening. If you missed the previous episode of this series, there's an annotation on screen on the right hand side to take you to it, although of course feel free just to drop back to the channel page and find it there. If you aren't subscribed to the channel already and you'd like to do so to make sure you don't miss out any of this series and the My Player series, then feel free to hit the subscribe button. There's a link in the description and an annotation on screen as well, just to help you out with that. And if you don't follow me on Twitter as well, feel free to do so. At Chesnoy Gaming is the Twitter handle. There's a link to it in the description as well. But that's all for today, guys. Thank you very much for watching. We have the most insane offer for one of our players in tomorrow's AC Milan career mode videos. It is not to be missed. But that's all for now, guys. I will see you next time.